with Jorge Masvidal and the kind of flip that happened between him and Jake? What do you know about that?
I'm not sure. I don't know. And I'm not going to speak on Jorge's behalf. We went to his gym one time. We trained with him a little bit. Not too much, just messing around. And he was very, very gracious and very nice. And something obviously happened along the way, and as it does in sports sometimes. And, you know, now Jake's fighting Tyron. And Tyron and Jorge have been, you know, teammates for a long time. And Jorge's kind of riding with this guy, which is understandable. So I don't really think it's too much bad blood, except for the fact that, you know, in the fight world, that happens sometimes. And I'm going to stay out of that. I don't know.
DJ, from your experience, this journey, where you started with Jake with no belief in him, no one done, now you're a pay-per-view on Showtime. How's it been from your perspective?
I told him when I first went to Big Bear, they called me in December 19th to go in as a sparring partner before the Gibb fight. And, you know, it was kind of crazy. I didn't really know who he was. And once I went into camp with him and sparred with him, I always like sparring with somebody to feel like what they do well. And, you know, I was 3.5-4 years removed from a world title fight. I wasn't in great shape, but at the same time, I still, for a couple rounds, I was a handful for anybody. And when I got in there and I felt what he was able to do and how he was able to attack, as green as he was, as inexperienced as he was, I liked the nuts and bolts of what he had. I really did. And I was like, you know what? I can do something with this kid. He's tough. He speaks his mind. He's a hard worker. He's a tremendous athlete. People don't know that about him, but he can take a shot and he can give a shot. Trust me. And this was, you know, this was 2 years ago. I just feel like I saw a lot of potential then. I saw a lot of possibility. And once we started cleaning up some of the basic mistakes he was making, he really started transitioning into a fighter who looked like he'd been fighting a lot longer than he has. He's got a tremendous team around him. I'm not even talking about myself. I'm talking about all around the board. Jacob Chavez, Jay Leon Love, his assistant Marcos, his strength and conditioning coach,
Chef. Cut.
Yeah, Chef Byron, Jay Leon, like I said, Ocean Inner being the guy who does all his healing and his massages and everything. I mean, there's so many components to this great team, and he's got a good team around him. So I'm not surprised, to be honest with you. But to be in his second 8-round fight on a Showtime pay-per-view on a platform as large as Showtime, I mean, it's incredible. I mean, when has that ever been done?
In a fourth fight.
In a fourth fight, in an 8-round fight. I mean, that alone is credible right there. Most guys are still fighting 4 rounds. Much less 6-rounders now. His second 8-rounder already wins 3-0. That's he's working his ass off. So, got to give him credit.
So you did get hit by Jake. It's sparring.
About 2 years ago, yeah. He took a couple himself, but I definitely got hit a couple times, yeah.
What'd you make of yesterday's events?